how we can write, how, suppose I would like to write any Java programming, how I can write, what are the steps will be there. So whenever we want to write the any Java programming, generally these are the some basic units of steps will be there. We need to, if required, we need to import the statements. Java is purely an object-oriented programming language, like encapsulation, inheritance, polymorphism. We can define the class, we can define the method, you can write the logic, we can save the program, compile the program, and then execute the program. So these are the some steps. Whenever you want to write any Java programming, we need to import a statement. You can define the class, we can define the method, we can write the logic, we can save the program, then compile the program and execute the program. How we can execute these? Now we will go through with the simple program. Either you may go to an editor, notepad, notepad++, or we may go through an editor called notepad. So what is the first statement? Already we have discussed some steps, import a statement. So what is the import? Import java.lang.star, and I am saving my program as save as. In the E drive, I am saving the programs. E drive demo dot. Yes. So the first statement is, you need to, even it is somewhat, even it is a first lecture, if you have any confusion, just the basic syntax identify. So first we can write an import, importing of a package is import java.lang.star. It is a default package. Actually there is no need of importing this statement, automatically it will be imported, but I am just writing import java.lang. It is a, every Java program must have at least, every Java program must have at least one class. So how we can define the class? The syntax is class followed by class name. So this is the syntax for Java. So we can import a packages, import package name dot star, and how the class, the class syntax is class space class name. It is the syntax, and you can open the class body and you can close the class body. And now what is the class name, how I can set and how I can write, and how to save it. So all those steps we can discuss one by one. And now class name, once the class is defined, next what we need to define, method. Method will be required. So import the statements, class, how we can define the class, class space class name, and after that we can define the method. And now I am removing again this. This is the syntax, class. What is the class name? Demo I am giving. Class open. Yes. What is the define? We know that in the C language also, we have a method called main. In Java also we have a method called main. But the declaration of main, declaration of main is done with three keywords. What are those three keywords? One is public, the access specifier. The main will be declared with an access specifier It can be accessed from anywhere. That's why it should be declared with a public. Main will be accessed from anywhere out of the program. It need to be accessed. That's why it should be declared with a keyword called public keyword. Second one, it will be declared with static. So that meaning main will be automatically called without any object. Actually, you can remember. So no object. It is only one method. Automatically, the program execution will be started from the main method. How it will be possible? With the help of static keyword. Without object, main method is called automatically. That detailed implementation steps will be learned when you are using a keyword, when you are learning a keyword called static keyword. And third one, the return type is void, no return type. So Java have a class, yes, class demo, and within that we are using the main. Main should be declared with a keyword called, three keywords are there. Three keywords. What are those three keywords? Public, static, and void. Now, public, static, void. If you have observed the keywords are indicated in a blue color. There is a separation. And what is the function method name? Main. And main also have one argument. One argument is there. What is that argument? String array. That is, it is having a string array. And yes. So this is the signature. The class, we have started the class. What is the class name? Demo. What is the method? Main method we have defined. Main method will be declared with a three keywords. What are those three? Public, static, void. Yes, public, static, void. And main method, it have one argument called string array. That is, string args will be there. It is an array. And now, you want to do anything? Yes, print. How we can, in the C language we have a print printf statement. In the Java for printing, we can use system class outstream dot println of my first Java program. My first Java program. System dot out dot println of println. It is a comes under a stream, output stream of which class? System class. System dot out dot println. So all these are just for theory purpose. It is a multi-line comments. We can add it. Multi-line comments. And now it is a program actually. We have imported a java.lang package because system class is there in the java.lang. Class demo. The main method is declared with the three keywords, public, static, void, main of string args. How we can print it? System.out.println of my first Java program. Save as filename.java. Filename.java. Where it was saved, it will be saved in the F drive. Now, how we can execute? Go to the command prompt. Go to the command prompt. Yes, where it was in the F drive, Java C space. What is our file name? The first step is, again we can go back. If you have observed, importing the statements are completed. import java.lang, define class completed, class name. We have defined a method, public static void main. We have written a logic, very simple, just printing system.out.println. We saved the program, filename.java, and now we are in the step called compile program. If you want to compile program, we will go to the command prompt. How we can go to the particular driver? Where did you save the program? I have saved my program in the F drive. F colon I moved Java C space filename dot Java. And now the compilation is completed. How we can execute Java space demo? So automatically it is generating a class called, what is it? Demo dot class is there, Java space demo dot class. Automatically it will be there. So what it I have executed the program Java space demo. My first Java program is executed. Why I have given the capital letter? So better to use whatever compilation is done small letter, because I have saved my file with demo.java, but execution definitely you need to supply. The main method is available in which class? Demo class. So with the same name you need to execute. If you have any confusion, just you can be save the file name initially, save the file name and class name with the same name. So again I can compile Java C demo dot Java Java space demo will be there. So my first Java program, the output was generated. So this is the way for writing any Java program. So even if you have removed this, no problem, because that is an automatic package. Whenever you have compiled the program, that package is automatically imported. Actually, there is no need of explicitly importing a statement called java.lang, but we need to aware it is a default package automatically imported. Similarly, if you want to write any statement, so if you want to write any print statements, we can write it. If I want to write hello, we can save it. Even you have added one statement, every time definitely you need to compile the program. Java C demo.java. Compile, and now Java space. Yes, what are the two program statements? My first Java program and as well as hello is printed. So in this way we can compile the program and we can run the programs. And is there any other statements are there? Is there any other alternatives are there to write the programs? No. So without class and without functionalities, we can't write the programs. So even you are trying to write the programs without class, suppose I didn't define any class, directly I have written a program like C language, public static void main string args, then what will be happen? Just compile the program. What it is asking? Class interface or enum is expected. That meaning is at least you need to use any class or interface or enum to define the methods. So without those it can't be possible. So we are trying to write any class, any statements, printing statement without class, it will be generating a error also. Class demo let me close open this. Yes, it was compiled. It was compiled and it will be run. And now you know the variables. Separate concept will be there. But if you want to declare any variables, yes, you may declare int a equal to 10, int b equal to 20. You can declare as a separate. And you can perform C equal to A plus B. Or you can single step, you can define int A comma B also. So here I have declared two variables of integer type A of integer type A equal to 10, B of integer type 20 and C equal to of integer type, and I am trying to add. How I can print it? System dot out dot println of, if you want to print only C value, just you can directly give the name. Directly give the C value, system dot out dot println of C. And now we can compile Java C, depmo dot Java, Java space. Yes, my first Java program hello and 30 is there. Just it is simply printing the values. You want to give before 30, you want to print any message, sum is, then you can write within the double quotes, because printing statement is a string type, sum is. Okay, a concatenation symbol, not comma. Here the concatenation symbol is plus. Sum is the concatenation symbol. You want to add anything, concatenation symbol is plus. So this is what it indicates. The sum is, and for this sum I am trying to add a variable called C. And now compile the program. My first Java program, hello, sum is 30. Will be printed. Sum is 30. So this is the way for declaring of integer variables. Similarly, you want to declare, hello, I am belongs to CSE, I belongs to ECE. You want to declare, you want to print any messages. Yes, we have a data type, string. So already you know that, string. String name equal to CSE. String, what is the variable? Name. What is the data type? String. S is capital. It is not a basic data type. It is a string data type. S is a capital. And I am storing a CSE. How I can print system dot out dot println of hello. What is that? Name. We are concatenating the hello name. Save the program. And now compile the program. Java C demo dot Java, Java space demo. Yes. Hello sum is 30. Hello CSE. There is no space. Why? Because here you didn't give any space. You want to add the space? Just you can add the space here. Again, compile the program. Compile the program. Yes, run the program. Hello, CSA is printed. In this way, you can define any number of classes, any classes, and as well as methods, and you can write execute the programs. And now we have seen the integer variables and as well as string variables. We have seen the integer variables, string variables, and you want to declare any float. Yes, float, you know, in the C language, float f equal to 3.14 f. F indicates it is a single precision, because we have a data type called double also. So to store any single precision values, you can declare a variable f which belongs to a type called float type, and 3.14 f. We can write system dot out dot println of f. What it can gives, again, even you have changed single value, you need to compile the program. Java C demo dot java java space demo. Hello sum is 30, hello CSC, and 3.14 is printed. What are the other ones? Yes, we have a data type double also there. Double salary equal to we want to print anything. Can't find this. Okay, here it is not D, it will be, what is the error? I am giving the D, but I have declared as a salary. So we need to define the salary, not D. That's why it is generating an error. What is that? Undefined symbol. Now we can compile the program. Java's demo. Yes, is there any possibility to print all the statements in the single line, or is there any possibility to print in the same line? Yes, we can define one more program. Write a Java program to display number, name, and branch. How we can define? First statement is, what is the step one? Import the package, import java dot lang dot star. Next class, it is not displaying any keywords colors because we didn't save the program. First save the program. This is my sample program, sample dot java. Now automatically the keywords will be changed with a blue color class. What is the class name? Sample. And now define the class body is defined. Now define the main method. How we can define public static void main of string args. And now print the statement. First, what they are asking, display the number, name, and branch. So define the variables. Define variables. Roll number is a, suppose you can define the roll number as a integer type, and after that string name equal to, suppose I am giving my name Priya, and branch string, branch is a mixing up characters, the branch is CSC, and here the roll number is 501. I am giving, it is an integer, and now we want to print in the same line system dot out dot println of, first I want to print hello. For this I want to print roll number hello with some space. I would like to concatenate roll number completed. For that I want to give, after that I am expecting my output like this, hello 501 Priya CSC. I am expecting my output like this. This is my expected output. So roll number, after roll number what we are giving some gap, so again you can put some space in the double quotes. Now what is the next one? 501, already roll number Priya, where the Priya is there, there is a variable called name, concatenate it now, and after that what you are giving, space. And then branch. Again I am repeating, first I need hello, I kept in the double quotes, plus after that I would like to print the roll number, so add the roll number. Now you can give some space, again concatenate space, then print the name, yes, and after that give the some space, yes, branch will be there. So instead of printing all in the separate lines, I am printing entire thing in the same line. Now we can compile the program. What is the compilation step? Java C sample.java, it is expecting semicolon, where, yes, I forget to put the semicolon here. Java C sample compile, now Java hello 501 Priya CSC. So the entire thing will be displayed on the same line. In this way we can do the different types of printings, different types of things we can do. And now what are the data types we have focused? We have focused on the integer, we have focused on the group of characters, we have focused on the string, we have focused on the float, focused on the double data type. You have another data types like long data type is there, short data type is there, byte data type, and character data type. You can use different types of data types in our programming structure, because without the data types, without the variables, without capability of storing anything, we can't do the programs. So whenever you want to store the variables, that should be possible in the memory. You want to store any data, we can define the variables. The way of defining the variables is, you can go to the data type space variable name. Whenever you want to define any variables, you can go to the variables declaration. The syntax is data type space variable name 1, name 2, name 3, up to n you can define. So all these variables are belongs to the same data type, and you can assign the values directly, or you can take the values from the user also. So four variables I have declared with a type called integer type, and two variables I am declaring a variable called float type, and three variables I am declaring L1, L2, L3 with a long data type, and one more variable I am declaring with a type called double data type, and one other variables I am declaring with the S1, S2 or string type of name, branch. I am declaring with a string type. I am declaring another variable with a type called byte p. I am declaring a variable called character type. I am declaring a variable called true or false with a data type called boolean type. So all these are different types of variables we can declare, we can use in the our regular programming. And if you have seen the method also, definitely the method should be declared with a return type, whether it may be void or it may be integer or some other, but the main have separate scope. The main should be declared with, along with the no return type, it have two more keywords called public and static keywords, and the main have the arguments called, what is that, string args also we need to define. And now this is the class, today's class. Just I would like to summarize what we have learned in this class, what are the concepts will be comes under this content is. So initially we have focused on the why we need to, you need to learn the Java. Java is a high level language, object oriented programming language, secure programming language. And the second one I am asking, who developed the Java language? Who is the lead of Java programming language? James Gosling system. Where it was developed? In which company, which corporation it was developed? Microsystems. Currently, it was handover by which company? Oracle was handover the Java programming, Sun Microsystems. Fine. And now, what are the next followed by? We have focused on what different types of applications. And by using the Java, we can develop the web technologies, web applications you can develop, mobile applications, distributed applications, IoT based applications. Yes, we can develop different types of applications using the Java language. Next, followed by, what are the features of Java? Java is a robust language because it is an exception handling and garbage collection. Java supports multi-threading. Java is a purely object-oriented approach, encapsulation, inheritance, polymorphism, classes, objects. Java is a simple. Java is a high performance language. Java is a distributed. Java is a secure, and all these are different features of Java programming language. And the main important feature is Java is a platform independent. How the Java achieves the platform independent? It is a two-stage system. Java converts the source code into byte code, and the byte code will be executed on the any operating system. And later we have discussed the concepts of how to write a simple programs. So here, to write any program, we need to define them, import the packages, and after that every Java program must have at least one class. The class should be declared with a class keyword, defined with a method, public static void, main object.